In this video, we're going to become familiar with the new BCC Plus Flutter Cut transition inside of Boris Effects Continuum 2023.5. So I'm going to be demonstrating this to you inside of Premiere Pro, but this works in the exact same way inside of Final Cut Pro, Avid Media Composer, and DaVinci Resolve, to name a few. This is an extremely erratic and fast-paced transition, cutting between the A and B side of the edit, otherwise known as the outgoing and incoming clip. You've probably seen it in a music video. Sometimes Flutter Cut is used to cut to the beat of the music. Other times it's used to add tension. It's also used narratively in feature film, as we can see in this example from Easy Rider. So I'm here inside of Premiere Pro. I've got two clips in my timeline, and it just so happens I've done a search under my effects tab for BCC plus Flutter. You'll find this in the BCC transitions category, and I'll apply it into the edit point of my clip. I'll move my playhead a little bit earlier, and let's just give this a full screen playback by pressing Control tilde. And I can see that quick cutback between the A side and B side of the edit. But if I escape out of here and then just move my playhead over that, some video glitch overlaid on top of the effect. Now, with any BCC Plus effect, you can select it. We can head to Effect Controls, and at the very top is an effects editor. If you click on that badge, we're going to go into a separate workspace. And on the left-hand side, you have the opportunity to choose from a number of curated presets. On the right-hand side, you have the properties of that transition or effect that you've selected, as well as a dedicated workspace. So in looking at some of these presets, I'll just select Invert Mono. You can see that effect overlaid on top of the Flutter. We've got various levels of video glitch, a pure monochrome effect with a dissolve built into it, as well as one with directional blur. In this instance, to become more familiar with this, I'm going to cancel out of the effects editor, choosing not to save any changes. And I'm back here in Premiere Pro, where I can still see my effect controls. I'm just going to scroll down in the effect to temporarily disable any type of effects on this clip. I'm going to set that to off, so we can just focus on the movement between this outgoing and incoming source. So if I direct your attention to the top of the effect, right now there's a number of outgoing start frames set to 2, and a number of ingoing start frames matching that number. If I move my playhead to the beginning of the transition, and then start to press the right arrow, we can see that the incoming clip holds for 2 frames, followed by the outgoing clip. One thing that we might want to do first is set up the duration of the transition first, do a little bit of math, and then plug some numbers into that Flutter Cut ingoing and outgoing clip duration. I'm going to double click the transition here in the timeline and change it to 90 frames. I'll follow that with the Enter key. Transition gets longer. And under my outgoing clip settings, I'm going to set this value to 10. And I'll have the outgoing end frames match that 10. I'll just tab down also to the incoming start frames, matching those values that I set in the outgoing clip settings. What we're going to see is a much slower flutter. I'll move my playhead earlier, and we can see that now it happens over a 10 frame duration. You can check that out by just pressing the right and left arrow keys and counting the number of frames before it flutters over to another clip. Another handy thing about Flutter Cut is that we can also introduce a little bit of a fade out by changing the outgoing and the incoming fade in to different numbers in order to add a dissolve into the mix. In this instance, I'll just set both of these numbers back down to 0. And we'll follow this up by looking at the color section. We can introduce a number of color frames that will be spliced into the mix between the quick cutting of the outgoing and incoming clip. In this case, I'll set color 1 frames to be 5. And if I move my playhead back once again, press that spacebar, that 10 frame flutter cut for my incoming and outgoing clip, and that insertion of the white frames happening for 5 frame increments. You can change the color effect order to happen. Right now it's happening after both the incoming and outgoing clip, but we can have it just so it happens after, let's say, the incoming clip, and that will change when those white frames get interspersed in this cut. In addition to this, you saw earlier that there's an effect section, and we can add a type of effect during the transition period. In this case, I'm just going to stick to a very simple monochrome look. Right now, the target is set to both, but we can have this effect be applied to just one side of our edit. So I'm going to apply it to the outgoing clip. So we can see that this frame isn't affected. If I move a couple frames back, we can see that that outgoing clip is the one that is monochromatic. And once again, I'll play that back so we can see how the Flutter Cut responds. Now let's just see this over another example. I'm going to head here and change to my effects workspace to reveal my music video Flutter Cut timeline. I'll go back to my effects tab and add Flutter Cut to these sources and just play back where we can see the rapid cutting between these two shots. Let's select the Flutter Cut. And with the outgoing and the incoming frames, I'm going to set the outgoing start frames to be 10, but the incoming, I'm going to set that to 1. So just a quick, rapid incoming frame that we have. We'll leave the fade outs as is. We're not going to add any color, but we will go down to the effects section and actually change this from video glitch to film grunge. This film grunge, which is overlaid on top of the Flutter, we can bring down the effects amount if we want it to be less harsh, as well as if you scroll even further down, there happens to be a film grunge section which becomes highlighted. That's here where we can randomize the pattern of the grunge which appears during the transition. If I move my playhead back, we can see that pattern intermix between those two clips. I'll head back to my effect controls and see that if we now go to video glitch, same thing, we have an effect amount, which we can increase or decrease, but video glitch has its own properties further down, a seed value to randomize the glitch, not to mention an intensity, which is set pretty low. So if we wanted to increase this, we can drag up that intensity amount and then just play with the overall effect amount, which acts more like a dissolve. We can now scroll up. Let's maybe add a few colored frames. I'm going to change this color, first of all, to an orange rather than the standard white for color one. And we'll intercut 4 colored frames at a given time. Let's move our playhead earlier. I'll just do a full screen playback so we can see this intercutting of the video glitch and the quick cuts between the outgoing and incoming clip based on the values that I've set. And there's a whirlwind tour of the Flutter Cut transition. Check out some of those presets in the effects editor, not to mention the properties there of effects that you could overlay on top today. For more tips and tricks just like this, don't forget to like and subscribe as well as comment on this video. You can also check out some other new features in Continuum 2023.5 at borisfx.com.